inside, of course. Gwendolen was very much pleased on one account, and a little the other way in another, pleased with the new clothes and the improvement which they had achieved, less pleased by the pink in the buttonhole. Yesterday's pink had hardly interested her. This one was just like it, but somehow it had got her immediate attention, and kept it. She wished she could think of some way of getting at its history in a properly colorless and indifferent way. Presently she made a venture. She said, "Whatever a man's age may be, he can reduce it several years by putting a bright-colored flower in his buttonhole. I have often noticed that. Is that your sex's reason for wearing a boutonniere?" "I fancy not, but certainly that reason would be a sufficient one. I've never heard of the idea before."
"You seem to prefer pinks. Is it on account of the color or the form?"
"Oh, no," he said simply. "They are given to me. I don't think I have any preference."
"They are given to him," she said to herself, and she felt a coldness toward that pink. "I wonder who it is, and what she is like."
The flower began to take up a good deal of room. It obtruded itself everywhere. It intercepted all views and marred them. It was becoming exceedingly annoying and conspicuous for a little thing.
"I wonder if he cares for her."
That thought gave her a quite definite pain. End of chapter 20. The American Claimant by Mark Twain. Chapter 21.
She had made everything comfortable for the artist. There was no further pretext for staying. So she said she would go now, and asked him to summon the servants in case he should need anything. She went away unhappy, and she left unhappiness behind her, for she carried away all the sunshine. The time dragged heavily for both now. He couldn't paint for thinking of her. She couldn't design or millinerize with any heart for thinking of him.